Why am I wearing all of this for a horse race? Oh, I'm sorry. It's because I'm racing a seahorse. Ah! A seahorse, get it? Oh, I'm not really, it's just a joke. Oh, what a wheeze. Oh, yes.
Oh, hello. I can't wait to open this up and look inside. Do you know what it is? Well, yesterday, the nature detectives made a bird bath with cement and cabbage leaves, and now it's time to find out if it worked. Oh, but I suppose I better wait for the nature detectives to help. So in that case, why don't we run titles? Welcome to CBeebies Springwatch, and... Oh, I really want to open the bag. Oh, come on, nature detectives! Oh, yes, I forgot. They're in the hatching house with the ducklings. Oh, I suppose we're just going to have to wait. Oh, no, I know. I can tell you what we've got in today's program, apart from this bag, of course. We'll be getting up very early to see what wildlife is awake in Paige and Owen's patch. The nature detectives will be doing some in-depth investigation about squirrels. And we'll be finding out why Bill is dressed as a haystack. And of course, someone will be hiding in the hide. I love that bit of the program. I want to open the
bag. Nature detectives to Jackson. Come in, Jackson.
There they are. Hello, nature detectives. Where are you?
House and we're ready for our report.
Very good, nature detectives. Why don't you give us the latest news and then we can unwrap your bird bath. Over.
It's springtime, it's springtime. Time to wake up and sing. It's springtime, it's springtime.
Time to wake up.
Time to wake up.
Time to wake up. It's spring.
Today in the hatching house, I've got Honey here with me, and I'm joined by...
Evie and Daisy May.
Kyle and Sunny.
OK, that's great. So we'll pop them back in now, shall we? They can go back under the brooder. Do you want to give me Daisy May? There we go. And Sunny. There we are. Now go back up there. They're looking nice and strong, aren't they? And so who do you think the youngest is, then?
Honey, I think Honey.
I think... Is that Honey?
Yeah, that's Honey.
I think Honey.
That's right, she is the youngest. And there's another way you can tell. I'm just going to get Honey again here.
Oh, can we all go, Honey?
No, we'll just get Honey this time. Now, can you see right at the end of her beak?
Yeah.
You see what's there?
Yellow stuff.
Yeah, that little thing just there. See what that is? That's called the egg tooth. Why do you think she might have an egg tooth?
Because that's a baby tooth.
That's exactly it. It's just like a baby tooth. She uses that to break out of the egg. Now, the others have lost theirs already. You can't see the egg tooth, can you?
No.
So our ducklings are looking really healthy here in the hatching house.
So that's very exciting, isn't it? Now, it must be nearly time to look in here. Oh, I wonder when the nature detectives will be here. Hello? Who's that calling?
Nature Krista Jackson. We'll be over in a minute to unwrap the bird bath.
Oh, good. Very good. I'll be waiting for you.
Great. Over and out.
While we're waiting, perhaps we could go over to Paige and Owen. I think they're doing a bit of bird watching. I wonder if they have a bird bath. What's in your patch?
Hello, I am Paige.
I am Owen.
And this is our dad.
And this is your pap.
We live here on an island called Guernsey. It's one of the Channel Islands. It's very early in the morning. We like to watch the sunrise over the sea.
See the sun.
It's very beautiful and worth getting up for extra early. We like walking through this wood. We come here to listen to the dawn chorus. This is when all the birds wake up and sing to each other. They wake up as soon as the sun starts to rise and it gets light. This part of the morning is called dawn. Our dad is very good at spotting birds. He teaches us their names. He also knows birds by the songs they sing. We have to be very quiet so that we can hear them. I wonder what birds we'll hear today. Listen to the birds singing.
I go to...
We can hear lots of different songs. It sounds like music. In this wood, there are pretty flowers growing. They are called bluebells. The petals are shaped like bells and they are blue. Look at how many there are. They are so pretty that the wood is named after them. It's called bluebell wood. We love listening to the birds singing in bluebell wood with our dad. We hope you did too. Thank you for visiting our patch.
The moment we seem to have been waiting ages for, the unwrapping of the bird bath. Go on, Edge Detectives, get on with it. Yes. Wow.
Okay, now we'll try and turn it over.
Turn it over.
Whoa. There we go, and should we try and peel some of these leaves off?
Look at the patterns, Jackson.
Oh, yes, the leaves have made patterns in the cement.
Yeah, and that's really important because it means that the birds can grip. It's not all slippy.
Oh, that's clever. I was wondering, do birds get very dirty then?
Yes, and they use the bird bath to get clean again and to drink.
Oh, so there are drinks at the bird cafe as well.
That's right, and once we've got this in position, we'll be ready to go bird watching.
Oh, I wonder what sort of birds we're going to spot today.
Springtime, time to wake up and sing. It's springtime, it's springtime. Time to wake up, time to wake up, time to wake up. It's spring.
It started when I was seven and I drew a picture from my school teacher, the kingfisher.
Yeah.
And from that moment on, I've been completely obsessed.
I would love to actually be close to the kingfisher. Right. Any chance of that?
I think we can do it.
Can you?
You might look a bit silly, but I think we can do it.
Look silly? Moi?
Yes.
Why am I laughing? Now, apparently, this is the prime fishing spot on the river, and the theory is that the kingfisher flies in and perches bang on the top of the large stick before my very eyes.
With Charlie in his hide, me in a haystack and a stick. Got an itchy nose. Even if I twitch, it will scare the bird away. And it could be anything from 5 minutes, 5 hours. I'm gonna have to close my eyes. Pass into some other state of consciousness. Here it is. It is gone. Did you see that? Used to cliches, aren't you? Plonk. nothing. Down. Nothing. Down. Yes. Go on, eat it. Go on. It'll bash it. Now. It will. Make sure it's got the head first. Proving me wrong, it's going down tail first. That's no good. It's already looking straight at me. That was extraordinary.
Wasn't that kingfisher a beautiful bird? I'd love to spot one of those. Didn't Bill look funny, dressed up as a haystack? I wonder if the nature detectives are going to dress up like that for their bird watching. I'll check later. But now, Gordon is here with his latest report on our foxes. Hello, Gordon.
Hello, Jackson. This old and rather bold fox is Jamie. He's a regular in my street, and a real chancer. Just as I was getting closer to knowing more about Jamie's life, he disappeared across the road, and I lost him.
He might be still fast in his feet, but he's an old fox, and old foxes slow down.
But I guess you don't get to such a ripe old age without taking a few chances in life. A new day, and I'm hoping to delve deeper into Jamie's world and find out why he risks his life crossing one of Glasgow's busiest roads. All that scent marking that Jamie did last night, it's like fox graffiti. It's their way of saying, this is my patch. I want to find out who he's trying to keep out. Now it's just a case of being patient.
Oh, that'll do.
So this is one of Jamie's neighbours. It's a much younger fox and not nearly as bold. I wonder if this could be a vixen that Jamie comes to visit. She keeps diving through that hedge. I wonder what's in there.
Straight into the hedge. That's just like the huge green area that extends all the way in there. I think it's worth checking it out, definitely.
It's springtime,
time to wake up and sing.
It's springtime, it's springtime, time to wake up, time to wake up, time to wake up. It's spring!
Let's fill the bird bath up so the birds can have a bath or a drink. And let's go and do some bird watching, shall we?
Yeah.
Yes. Yep,
this way. On we go. So here we are, ready to do some bird watching then. What's the first thing we should do, Detective Evie?
We should take our coats off so the birds can't see us and we can look without them seeing us.
That's right. So if we take these off, we've all got green T-shirts on underneath, haven't we? There we go. So now let's be really, really quiet so we don't disturb the birds and get on with some bird watching, yeah?
I see a little brown bird and it's eating.
And do you know what kind of bird that is?
Not really.
It's called a dunnock.
I think I see something. It's got brown wings and a red chest.
Oh, yeah. And what do you think that might be?
A robin.
A robin.
Ah! There's a bird! I think I see a bird with a black and white head and a yellow chest.
Yes. Shall we have a look in the book?
Yeah.
Okay.
There it is.
Oh, so we've seen a great tit, have we? Do you want to draw the great tit?
Okay.
Oh, excellent.
I've got something. Oh, it's a squirrel. It's not a bird, it's a squirrel. I often see squirrels up here in Nature Detective Headquarters, Special Branch. I sometimes see them on the bird feeders, and I sometimes see them in the branches of trees. But I wonder where they go for the rest of the time. I'd say that's a job for the nature detectives. Nature detectives. Come in, nature detectives. Hello. Now, today's nature detectives in Salcy Forest are Jake, Olivia, Max, and Phoebe. Right. Now, I want you to follow a squirrel and see if you can find out what he gets up to.
Yeah!
You ready? Yes? Okay. Then get detecting. Now, I've sent top nature detective Dan to help them.
Nature.
We're looking out for nature.
Hey, detectives! Hey, how are you all doing? All right?
Yeah!
Should we go off and look for some squirrels?
Yeah, come on then,
let's go.
When you're trying to spot a squirrel, you should stay quiet and move slowly. You don't want to scare them.
Just be quite quiet.
And tracking them down.
And tracking them.
You just climbed up a tree. I just saw one. How small? There's one over there.
Oh, dearie me, I'm stuck.
Here.
Oh, my
hand.
Horrible.
Come on then, Max.
Look at how the hole.
I just saw one.
Do you think we'd like to see squirrels on the ground?
Yes. In autumn, squirrels bury food. In spring, you can see small holes. This is where the squirrels have been looking for their food.
Keep using your eyes and your ears.
I can see a nut.
You can see a nut?
I think I can see a nut in the hole.
There you can smell the food they have buried. And look how their noses twitch.
I see another hole.
The east pine cones.
What's this from?
They look like a pine cone.
Squirrels been eating.
We are going into the trees to get a bird's eye view of the forest.
There's one up there. There.
Squirrels can see really well from up here.
I've seen people!
Nature Hunts.
We're looking out for nature.
Nature Hunts.
What will we see?
Nature Hunts.
We're looking out for nature.
Nature Hunts.
Come along with me.
Where?
This
pool.
It went under
the...
Squirrels talk by calling and twitching their tails. Look how their tails twitch. Squirrels live in homes called drays high up in the trees.
There's one there. Look, it's a little nest.
Squirrels sleep in drays when it is cold.
There's one.
This is where the baby squirrels are born.
I can see one over there.
Baby squirrels are called kittens. Squirrels store food on the ground. They eat in the branches. They sleep in drays high in the trees.
That's just like me in my treehouse. Well, that's excellent detecting. Mission complete. Over and out.
Out and about with me, Special Reporter Jelly, and Justin. This is Special Reporter Jelly, live in the wild woods with my cameraman, Justin. Justin!
Hi there.
Yes. I've come here into the woods today to look for a very special squirrel.
Hey, Jelly!
What?
Hey, I've spotted one!
Oh, no, Justin, not that type of squirrel. I mean a really, really special squirrel.
Oh.
A red squirrel.
Oh, I see.
And I really, really, really want to see one.
Well, Jelly, you know what? I know just the place.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Come on, then.
All right. Come on. We're putting out some nuts and some seeds for the red squirrels because they love them.
Oh.
And hopefully Yes. We sit quietly.
Yes.
Shh, quietly. Yes. The red squirrels will come out and eat the nuts and seeds and we can take a look at them. Can you see anything yet, Jelly?
No. Come on, red squirrels. No, I think I can see one. I think I can see it peeking.
Are you right?
Yes, yes, yes. We have to be quiet, don't we, Justin?
That's right.
Shh, shh, everybody, shh.
Oh, look, there he goes. Whoa, isn't he fast?
Yes, he's running. Oh, look, he's landed on a swingy thing.
Oh, yes, so he has.
Yes, it looks like he's on a swing, little red squirrel.
Now, the red squirrel is actually smaller than the grey squirrel. Did you know that?
Yes, it does look very small.
He's got big, fluffy ears, hasn't he?
Yeah, they're dufty, aren't they? And he's got a really bushy tail. Oh, Justin, this has been my best day ever. Yes, I've seen my favouritest animal. Come on, let's go and do my report.
OK, come on then.
This is Special Reporter Jelly, reporting with groundbreaking news. Today I spotted my favouritest animal ever, the red squirrel. There aren't very many red squirrels in this country, so you don't see them very often. Red squirrels are a lot like grey squirrels, but red squirrels are smaller than grey squirrels, and the long, tufty bits of fur on their ears make their faces look really sweet. Special reporter Jelly. Oh, and cameraman Justin, out and about with red squirrels at the Wildwood.
Thank you, Jelly. That was great reporting. Oh, here come the nature detectives. What have you been detecting today?
I saw a brown bird and I drove it.
Okay, and what about you, Evie?
I saw a great tit feeding at the bird cafe.
Wow.
Yes, and there's loads more birds to detect, so we'll be doing some more bird watching tomorrow.
Oh, yes, and we've still got one more thing to detect today, haven't we?
Who's hiding in the hive?
Who's hiding in the hive? It's Basil Brush!
Hey, what do you think of the outfit, Linny?
It's very good. It suits you, Basil.
Yeah, a bit leafy for my liking. Bought it off a friend of mine called Russell.
Boom, boom!
Now, something's telling me you're not taking this seriously, you know. You see, we're here because we're going to take you to see one of Britain's top predators, the fox. In fact, we're taking you back to your roots.
Ooh. I'm a grey bit, shall we?
Oh, dear. Come on.
So, where are they then? Where are
they? Shh, Basil, you've got to be quiet and patient.
I'm sorry.
Is there anything at this rate?
So, no loud boom booms here?
No boom booms at all.
Sorry.
What now?
You know that penny I wanted to spend in the woods?
Yes.
It's turned into a fiver.
Just have some patience. Stop fidgeting.
I'd rather have 40 winks. Why don't you phone ahead and tell them that we're coming? Wake me up when they arrive, will you?
Basil, wake up. We've got a fox. Mm-hmm. A fox, look.
Oh, I see. The fox.
It's the corn fox. The red fox is what you are.
Looks nothing like me. Look at the state of his brash. Look, it's got no fur on it.
Well, that's what wild foxes do. It's part of being a wild fox. Mm. They have to molt their coat a couple of times a year.
Oh, it's a bit like me taking off my parka in the winter and putting on a T-shirt for the summer so I don't overheat.
I guess so, yes. The same sort of thing. Mm. They just don't have the advantage of your extensive wardrobe.
Yeah, well, they should get one, shouldn't they? I have to say, Nick. They don't have punk. What's that all about?
Well, this is what you've got to get used to, because foxes are incredibly smelly animals. In fact, it's one of the ways that you know a fox has been around, because you can smell that wherever they've been. But what it is how foxes communicate with each other.
Why don't they should talk to each other or send a letter, shouldn't they? Now, I see he's tucking into some food there. What's he eating? I couldn't eat this rubbish. I mean, there's nothing around here to eat.
They will eat everything from berries, seeds, nuts, all the way through to creepy crawlies, even birds and small mammals.
I tell you what, he looks a little bit like my cousin Mortimer, you know. And my cousin Mortimer owes me a fiver. Oi! You owe me a fiver, mate! Hand it over!
Oh, Basil, we're never going to make a wildlife presenter of you.
Oi, look, he's getting away. Oi, come in. Mortimer.
Well, here we are at the end of the programme again. Doesn't time just fly by? But don't worry, we'll be back tomorrow and we've got some great things for you. We'll be meeting Robin and Adele, who are farmers at their local city farm. The Nature Detectives will be finding out how birds build their nests. And Jelly will be back with her next nature report from the Wild Wood. And of course, the Nature Detectives here at Special Branch will be finding out more about how to do bird spotting. But for now, we leave you with our great Springs Out song, starring me. Oh, yes, and you, Chris. Yes, you do a bit of pointing in it, don't you? And some other people. OK, see you tomorrow. Bye! Bye.
Hello. Well, that's all we've got time for here on Get Set Go today. But don't worry, because we'll be back another day. And don't forget, if we didn't finish, then how could Chris and Poi discover and do with you all? You see, every silver cloud has a lining. Or is that every lining has a silver cloud? Oh, whatever. See ya.
Spring has sprung online, so grab your mouse and have acres of fun spotting with PC Plum. Get out and about looking for signs of spring, then stick what you spot in your sticker book. Oi, bunny, don't eat my carrots. You can paint your own animals. Let's start colouring in. Ooh, lovely job. And see your animals come to life. Natural fun for little ones at bbc.co.uk/CBeebies. Bloomin' marvellous.
Hello!
It's Discover and Do with me, Poi.
And me, Chris. Now, who's coming to play with us today on CBeebies, Poi?
Andrew says he has the clues.
Clues? As to who's coming up? Oh, hello, Andrew. Nice to see you. Now, let's read this clue. It says, you'll find this friend where you rest your head at night time when you go to bed.
Go to bed.
Go to bed. You go to bed in the bedroom. In the bedroom. Let's have a look. In the bedroom. Over to the bedroom.
Oh, look, there's Teddy. Teddy's resting his head.
Yes, but let's think about the clue. At night time where you rest your head. You rest your head on a pillow.
Oh, look. It's the Little red tractor. Yes, he'll be coming up very soon, down on the farm.
Oh, that's good. Can we have another clue, please, Andrew? Oh, thank you very much, Andrew. This clue says, water splish and water splosh. In this place, you give your hands a wash.
A sink.
A sink. Shall we try the kitchen sink?
Let's go!
This way! Oh, over to the kitchen sink. Is there anything
here?
Oh,
look, look, look! Mr. Tumble! Oh, yes,